Hey, big family. Right now, you're watching a very special episode of The Soundstage. We're here again at Two Caligas. You might remember when we filmed our friends The Metaphor here. And today, there's a very special event. David O'Dell, an American man, has written a book called Inseparable. It's about his adventures and his story discovering punk rock bands almost 20 years ago. And in addition to Dave's book, we'll also meet his favorite charity, Half the Sky. They give money to Chinese orphans, and all proceeds from tonight's event will go towards Half the Sky. So tonight, we hope to learn more about punk rock culture in China and show that punk rock isn't only about being wild and crazy, but also has a message about helping people. Come on, let's check out some of the bands. One of them hasn't played in over 10 years.
My name is David O'Dell. I came to China in 1995 and with no real goal other than to study Chinese language. I'm from Austin and it's a big music city and I had done a lot of music over there and I was kind of tired of looking at a bunch of just very shallow sort of pop bands getting a lot of exposure when I was really in love with this other kind of music. I really wanted to study Chinese. So I took one semester of Chinese at University of Texas at Austin and fell in love with the language. It was very poetic. It was very visual. It was very difficult, so it was a good challenge. I had some friends that were Chinese who liked a lot of alternative music, and we decided to throw a party. It was like a Kurt Cobain anniversary of his death party. And at that party, we threw it at a bar called Solutions at Beida Shimer at the west gate of Beijing University. Nobody had ever heard of punk rock music before. In fact, the characters that make up the word punk hadn't really been established. So even up until 1999, there were different characters for the word punk. You had like punk. So I kind of considered it one of the first punk shows, like a real punk rock band. When the audience heard them, we were just blown away. From two bands, we turned it into five bands, and then we turned it into seven bands, and then we turned it into a whole genre of music here in Beijing.
大家好，我们是密三刀，然后今天来参加这个活动是受戴维办的一个慈善的演出，然后因为我们是十多年前就认识。 然后是特别早的朋友，然后作为北京朋克，他写了一本书，然后我们也是尽自己力量为这个慈善活动做一些帮助吧。然后，对，反正是想跟社会证明朋克是可以做一些善事儿，比一些社会的慈善家可能更要真实。The
book is basically a very personal story of my years in Beijing doing music here. The charity is also a very, very important part of the show. I had gotten involved with the charity before, and I knew some really good friends of mine who had done activities with them and events. A solid charity, it's called Half the Sky, and it's a charity just for children who have disabilities or serious medical needs, cleft palate, club foot, I mean, you name it, cerebral palsy, all kinds of stuff. So these kids are like the most in need kids. And after I became a teacher, my heart kind of opened up to pretty much anything that had to do with education and childcare.
大家好，我是Flora， 我是半边天基金会的工作人员。半边天基金会是1998年成立的。 到现在已经在中国运作了10余年，并在50多个城市的福利院中开展了针对不同年龄段孤儿的教育和抚育项目。Dave chose our organization as his partner for this charity partner, and we are very happy to be here and have the chance to introduce our foundation to all the audiences and the guests coming here today, and to promote ourselves. among the punk population. Some of them show their interest about the work we are doing, because the children, because nobody, everyone would love to help, would love children and would do some little thing that they can do to help them. So it's no distinct, it's no difference for punk people or non-punk people.
刚才我特别感动，因为其实很多人都对摇滚乐，尤其是对 punk 音乐有很多的误解，就我们留着这样的发型，穿着那样的衣服，就感觉都是坏人。我觉得是这样啊，有好多不同的眼光吧。
我觉得那个慈善吧，是一个就是众人拾柴火焰高的这么一个事儿，就是无论你的能力大小，如果你愿意就是说帮一点小忙，这个肯定是就是对那些需要帮助的人有用。
All the book profits right now are going to the charity directly. I don't make anything from the book. It's the book wasn't really written to make money.So it was written to get the story straight.
This is the first item right here. This is an extremely, extremely rare 7-inch made in 1998. This is before the 无聊军队 CDs were made. 这个唱片是无聊军队那专辑压了之前，这个比无聊军队还要早，而且这个更特别。The recordings on this album are extremely unique. They were made just for this album. This was one of 500 albums. This is number 124 signed by hand. There are probably only a few left in existence. It's extremely rare. So I have to start this, I'm sorry, but I have to start this at 200 kwai. Do I have 200 kwai? Anybody? 200 kwai, I have 200 kwai. Anybody higher than 200 kwai? 300 块 ,300, 300块 ,300 块，还有比这个还有高 ,300 块，多少？
我们今天演出，一场演出是一个慈善演出，然后我们把所有赚过来的钱，包括主办方以及主办方赚过来的钱、广告费，还有那个所有观众的门票，我们都没有人会去拿这些钱，我们都会把钱捐给那些需要钱的小孩们，然后这些小孩们没有钱，然后不能像我们一样可以和父母要，他们可能没有人可以要的这部分钱，那我们做摇滚乐，我们有爱心。我们把钱搞过了，我把钱搞过来之后，哎，送给
说脏话，
送给他们。
没事。
对，我们把钱搞过来送给他们，然后希望每个人都能去，都能拿钱做些生意，然后那个去学校读书。
600块，这个所有的钱都是给那个四傻子。700块，太好，我都流眼，我流眼泪了。哎呦，太棒了！700块，所有的钱都是给慈善吗？
750。
750，750块，700，800块，800块给那慈善了，太棒了！还有了800块，800，800，800 going once，800 going twice，800 sold. Nice. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. David 是我们特别好的朋友，他从九。我们从96、97年我们就认识他，然后我去的第一个真正的朋克演出是他办的，我记得那会儿他办的是去为了送他妈妈回家。
我觉得这次办这个活动特别有意义，因为这些所有的钱，我刚才拍卖的钱是为了给那个梵天先捐给那些贫困的儿童，我觉得帮助他们是我们每个人的义务，我们应该用我们自己所有的能力去帮助他们，就是不管你的能力是大还是小，我觉得我们都应该尽自己的一份力去帮助他们。
What weSought out to do was get more people to listen to it. If punk rock music is able to inspire another kid to grab a guitar or grab some drumsticks and perform whatever they want to perform, let their individualism shine, then I think we hit a home run.
They raised over 6,000 RMB for the charity Half the Sky, and Gung Ho Films is going to match that. So that's over $2,000. I'd like to thank you all for watching this special episode of The Soundstage, and see you next time. Good night.